guys, this is Aiden's Toy Trove, and I have here with me the Briar Web Special Run St. Moritz. He has not been opened yet. Brand new in box, product number 712225. It's blurry there on the camera, so I apologize for that. This guy has actually been here for at least a few days, but I haven't had time to open him. So he's being opened for the very first time. He is the Esprit mold and a clearware decorator. I'm really excited about this piece. He was a Collectors Club a web special run earlier this month in November of 2017. I think the drawing was done on November 13th. There were, I believe, 380 pieces of this horse made. This is up from the normal, typical web special run of 350 pieces. The, however, I'm trying to think of the other web special run that I'm thinking of, Java. Java on the Nakoda mold, part of the Big Cat series, was limited to 255, I believe, and that seemed to not be enough to really meet collectors' demand. So I wonder if that was maybe part of the reason why Briar upped the number to 380. Again, typically the number seems to be about 350. Historically, Briar has released a silver filigree model around this time of year, Christmas time. So as a web special run, I'm not sure if St. Moritz is a Moritz is a replacement for the silver filigree that we usually see or not. I still have hopes that there will be a late silver filigree, but they may have released St. Moritz instead of the silver filigree this year. Also, I wanted to note that the Christmas Mare in Full set that Briar released this year was a unicorn mare in full, and they didn't really follow the traditional theme that Briar had going with the mare in the full set with the blankets. They had, let's see here, Crystal and Crispin, I believe, last year, who were the grazing mare in the grazing full, and really gorgeous apple gray and steel gray. And then they had these pretty blue snowflake blankets. And then the year before that, I think they had Even Claws, who were the nursing mare and the nursing foal, and kind of a really pretty frosted chestnut roan. Again, a realistic color with pretty, I think they're green plaid blankets. So Rosalind and Regal were new, and in that they weren't really Christmas themed. And this guy, St. Moritz, he is Christmas themed. In, well, not Christmas themed, he's winter themed. He's kind of a frosted blue, very pretty. I'm just getting a look at him for the first time here. And I'll get you a better peek as soon as I get his packing all organized here. He is a clearware decorator. Briar also did a clearware on this mold, which is the Esprit mold, sculpted by Kathleen Moody for Briar Fest 2016, I believe, for the Samba Surprise, who was released in a few different colors, but one of them was a clearware decorator. And I believe there were 149 of the glossy clearware decorator for the Briar Fest special run. And let's see here, 349 of the matte. And he was the rare color for the Samba Surprise. So here we go. Here is St. Moritz. He's really pretty. He's a very, very matte blue. Has a frosted look to him, which I believe was in the description that Briar had for this guy. One of the things I really like about this kind of this frosted color is that you don't see the air bubbles on the inside. The air bubbles can be distracting, I think, to some people. Like on Navia, the stablemate from 2017 Briar Fest on the Django mold was absolutely stunning, but you could see the air bubbles and some people didn't like that. So this blue paint is a great way of kind of avoiding seeing that, and it's really pretty. So I'm going to put him down here and I'm going to read Briar's description of St. Moritz to you. This is what they had posted on their website when he was available for sale. So Briar says, a winter web special. The magnificence of winter is on full display with St. Moritz. Sledding, ice skating, and riding in fresh snow are wonderful ways to enjoy the season. Breyer St. Moritz is a spirited equine that looks like an ice sculpture and is decorated with frosty blues and warming pinks. Clear snowflakes and windy swirls adorn his sides for an elegant wintry motif. Limited to just 380 pieces, St. Moritz will be gone before the snow melts, so act fast. He is marked St. Moritz 2017 on his belly and comes in a Breyer mail order box. Oh, I didn't check his belly. That might be new. I don't remember the past web special runs having the name on the bottom of the belly, but I didn't pay that much attention, so it's possible that they did. You did see when I opened this that he did not come in a retail box. He came in a mail order box. All the web special runs come in that plain white cardboard box. They don't have a retail box. What else can I tell you about this really pretty guy? I think I already said this, but he's number 712225. And I know that the lighting here is actually fairly horrendous, and you're not going to be able to see the true beauty of his color here at my very messy kitchen table. I am going to take some pictures of this guy in the photo tent, and I think he's going to come out just stunning. If you can't see it on the video, his blue is not a flat blue. It's a shaded blue. So he has lighter blues and slightly darker blues, and then he has this pink shading, pinkish purple shading on his hocks and his knees and on his muzzle and on the inside of his ears. His eyes, I believe, from what I'm looking at, are solid black. He has a silver snowflake on his forehead, and the snowflakes on his body are also painted silver. I'm gonna take a quick look at them. I'm trying to tell if they're decals, and I don't think these are decals. I don't feel any bumps or wrinkles, so I think these snowflakes are actually painted on. This white swirl that you see here, this is a painted on white. It's not the see-through plastic. Where the mane is also kind of painted a pearly white up at the top, and then it fades to the clear translucent tips at the mane, at the very tip of his mane and his forelock and his tail. So again, it's fading from a very light, very, very pale blue or even pearly white to a translucent clear color at the tip. It's really fairly awesome. His socks and his hooves are clear plastic. And this is really different. I really like this guy. I wonder if maybe Breyer had some leftover of the clear wares from Breyerfest, and that's why they had the kind of the odd run number of 380. That's a possibility. And this is a pretty popular mold. Again, he's sculpted by Kathleen Moody. For those of you that don't know, he is also the Gypsy Vanner mold, who has been completely retooled in Gypsy Vanner form. So it's kind of interesting to note that you probably may have noticed similarities between the Gypsy Vanner and the Spree mold, and that's why. They are two different versions of the same mold, which I think is pretty cool. I just love the clear plastic on him, and I especially really like how the tail goes from the frosty bluish pearly white down to the translucent tips. It looks really awesome. I'm excited to get this guy in my photo tent. And again, I don't think these silver snowflakes are decals. I think they're painted on. I don't feel any wrinkles. I don't feel any ridge that might be felt with a decal, but I haven't stuck my face right up there or gotten him under my super bright photo tent lights to check that. So I'd be interested to know how many of you guys received a St. Moritz. It seemed like a lot of people got him, and I think that's probably due to the run being slightly higher at 380. Plus, it's Christmas time, and I know a lot of people are broke. I'm totally broke, and model horses just might not be in the budget. Imagine that. Quality-wise, this guy looks really nice. Of course, I mean, he's not perfect. He's a mass-produced model. The only flaw that I'm seeing is in this little kind of where the seam is on his nose. There's a little divot that you can kind of see some chalky white maybe paint, or it could just be the plastic showing through. I know on some briars with the bare plastic, you get this little chalky look sometimes on just the unpainted plastic, and it can appear over time. I'm not sure what causes it, but that's a fairly minor flaw overall. I think Briar did a pretty good job with this guy. I like him. I'm really excited to get him in my photo tent. And then when I have pictures of him, I will provide a hyperlink for you guys so you guys can see him under full light, because right now it is dark, dark, dark out. No sunlight, it's totally dark. I was at the store all day and I kept telling myself, I actually have one of these at the store as well. And I've had him at the store for a week, and I told myself, hey, I'm gonna do a video of this horse while I'm at the store. And it's been one thing after another, and I haven't been able to do it. So I decided to open the one that I had at home. And I'm sorry for neglecting you guys. I know I haven't been very active on any social media channels. It's just been a really crazy time of year. But busy is good. Okay, so I'm gonna get this guy into the photo tent and take some pictures of him. Thanks for watching.